share my screen first. Is it visible? Okay. Sorry. I think we have started with this linked list. That linked list is a linear data structure that we have seen. So when we just talk about the linear data structure, so one is the linked list, second one is the array, and third one is the stacks and queues. So these are the linear data structures. So array, that linear data structure that we know, we are just taking this linked list and we'll just see stack and queue in the next. Okay, we have seen this introduction also. So definition we have seen, advantages, disadvantages, and some key terms, right? So here we know in a linked list there are multiple external pointers that we use to represent and to locate the linked list. Okay, so we have seen this also, the representation of node in C programming. So these, the two node structure we have seen, one is the simple linked structure and second one is the complex linked structure. So this already we have seen, and already I just told you, I have just created the data type, new data type, that is our own data type, that is a capital NODE, and type of that data type is struct node. Because we are using this type def, right? So using this one, we have created this capital NODE data type, and this small NODE and capital NODE both are different. Okay, so this is a complex. Now we have started with these operations on linked list. First operation, that how to create the new node, that we have seen, right? So to create a new node, we have these four steps. First step is to take any pointer, because without pointer we cannot locate or the find out the list. So for that we need one external pointer. That pointer we consider as a this stem pointer. Okay, and to create a new node, that is a consider that is an empty node, and that will be pointed to this the stem. So for that we have this statement, we have used this statement temp, this is a pointer, external pointer, and this is a syntax that is used to dynamically reserve the memory. So we are dynamically allocating the memory for this node using this statement, and then once we have this the node structure, then we can assign any value into this and into this also. But here as we consider this integer data type, so here we assign that 10, that is an integer type, and here we are assigning the null value. So that null is capital NULL. So this ASCII value of this capital NULL is the 0, right? And finally, when we just return this stem, it means this node will be returned. Okay? So this till this, I think we have seen function also. I just told you this function. That same whatever steps I just told you here, the same steps I have just written here in this function. This external pointer, this is a reservation of the node, and this we have accepted the value for that data from the user, and in temp of link means this part, in this temp of link we just assign this null value, right? So till this I think we just completed in last lecture. Now we'll just move for the next one of how to traverse the linked list, right? Now see, here I have not just told you how to create the entire linked list, just I just told you how to create a single node, right? But before just telling you the how to create the entire linked list, so I just wanted to take this point, that is a traversing a SLL, right? So traversing SLL, thus it means it is similar to traversing a array. Suppose you are having array, like array with four elements. So how do we traverse that, or how do we print the values? So for the traversing of that array, we take one index, that is I, right? And using any loop, we just traverse that I index to that array. like if you are using suppose for loop, so what we do for I equals to 0, I is less than suppose n or 4, whatever limit, and I plus plus. So I plus plus is what? That is a simply increment. Now in array, we know all the elements are stored in consecutive manner. So in that case, once you increment that I to the by 1, so it means it will go for the next location. But as we know in the linked list, so these nodes are scattered into the memory. If you see this the diagram, so in this case you can see this node, that is the first node, is stored at the 1000 location, right? And the next 1000 location would be 1001. But if you see the second node, that is at 2000 location, right? It means this memory location and this memory location are not in sequence, right? So around 1000 the blocks are there, memory blocks are there. So it means these are scattered into the memory. So these are not in sequential manner. So that's why that type of increment is not allowed here, like for I equals to 0, I is less than n, and I plus plus. So that kind of increment is not allowed here. So what or how we can the traverse this array, or sorry, this linked list. So what we do, see, this start means the original linked list, you can consider here. The starting means this original linked list. Now to traverse and see, keep in your mind, the neighbor, the change the position of the start, because the start represent your linked list, that is the original linked list, you can say, or updated, whatever, but this represent the linked list. So don't change this one. Now suppose you want to traverse the linked list, so you just take one external pointer, we consider that as a PTR, and assign that PTR to the start node, right, initially, because whatever are the addresses of the rest node, that we don't know. Only whatever is the address of this first node, that we know. How we know that address of first node? Because whatever is the address of this one, that already we stored into the start pointer, right? So that's why, and start we know it. So that's why take one PTR, that is a pointer, and assign that PTR to the start. So I have just written the statement here. How do we assign that PTR to the start pointer? You can see here. So PTR equals to start. So using this statement, we can assign that PTR to the start pointer, start node, and this is equivalent to I equals to 0 in case of array. Just I'm just telling you the comparison, right? So PTR equals to start means it is initialized to the first node. Now that condition is what? If you see here in this in array, if you see, so whatever is the last number that we know normally, like n or something, right? So that's why we traverse or we increment that I till n, right? But here we don't know which one is the last node and how many nodes are there into the linked list and something, right? So that we don't know. But if you see this linked list, so only this part that we know, you can see here the last node link part. So only this node is somewhat different, because last node link part is having that value, that is capital NULL, means null value, right? So zero value that it is having. So it means you can take pointer to from assigned to the start and just increment that pointer till you get that link part null value. Are you getting my point? So traverse your PTR till you get that link pointer null value, right? So here this is the termination condition, we can say. But how do we increment, like in the array I plus plus that we write? So here for the increment, you need to write this statement. You can see here PTR equals to PTR of link. Getting this? So how it would be? PTR equals to PTR of link. I'll just try to tell you somewhere into this. Okay. See, what I have written, the statement PTR equals to PTR of link. This statement I have written here, right? Now if you see here, if you see what is the address or whatever the PTR that is assigned to this, So that value is what? That is 1000, right? So here, if you see here, PTR equals to what is the, see here, this whatever this 10, that 10 field name is PTR of data. Getting my point? This part name is the PTR of data, and whatever is this field, that field name is PTR of link, or we can say start of link, but we are not using start because start is a fixed, right? So name of this one is either you can say PTR of data or you can say start of data, because two external pointers are pointed to this, and the name of this field is the PTR of link, or we can say PTR of start. Now see, if you see here, which value has been stored here, if you see here, so whatever is the next value, next node value, that is being stored here. So actually here, if you see, this 2000 is being stored here. For simplicity, I just write this 3000 and here 4000, right? So if you see here, so this 2000 is being stored here because this field is reserved for the address of the next node. So name of this field is PTR of link, and that value which is stored here is the 2000. So if you see here, PTR of link means which value? We can say 2000. So here we can say 2000. It means now what would be the PTR value recent? That is 2000. That's why we can say here this PTR will be moved to this one, because here that 2000 is. Getting my point? Now again, suppose you want to transfer this PTR from here to here. So how do we transfer? Same statement you can use here. If I same use like PTR equals to PTR of link, if I write now PTR is what? The previous PTR is 2000, right? And PTR of link, 2000 of link is which value? You can say this PTR means 2000, this one. So this PTR of link is this, or we can say 2000 of link is this one. It means this is 3000. So here it means we can say this PTR of link is 3000. It means next PTR value would be 3000. Getting my point? Now your PTR will be moved to this 3000. Now again, we can say do the same thing. Here again, we can use now recent PTR is 3000. And 3000 link part is 4000. So it means PTR equals to 4000, right? So here, if you see, that PTR will come to this point. Now again, now PTR is pointing, or PTR is at 4000. Again, you are, if suppose doing same thing here. So here 4000, and 4000 link part is what? Null. Getting this? It means PTR value is null. It means till this point you need to increment your PTR, and here increment statement is what? PTR equals to PTR of link. Just keep in your mind, right? So this one, PTR equals to PTR of link, this is equivalent to I++. Getting my point? And this is again equals to I++. And this PTR equals to start means I equals to 0, that is to the first location, or we can say in this linked list to the first node. So PTR equals to start means it is pointing to the first node, and using this PTR equals to PTR of link, we are just transferring or traversing this PTR from this node to this node, from this node to this node, from this to this, right? Till last node, you can traverse your PTR. So see, once we know that traversing, then while traversing you can print the nodes, while traversing you can print these addresses, or using this one also we can insert or delete the node. So that's why I'm taking this one, because this is most important. Once we know that traversing the pointer, then we can perform the other operations. Now see, that same function I just told you here, simply one statement I have written. This statement is what? Which is this statement you can see here, for ptr equals to start, it means you can say in array I equals to 0, this is ptr of length is not equals to null, this is like I is less than n, and this is ptr equals to ptr of length, it is like I plus plus. And see, don't forget to put here semicolon, because simply we are incrementing that I value, we are not doing any other things. So that's why don't forget to put here this semicolon. It means this for loop is ending here, right? And whatever is the recent value of this one, that you can return it. So any doubt in this? So traversing of SLL. So it's very simple function. Only here you need to know this increment statement, right? Increment statement is ptr equals to ptr of length. So using this statement, we can move to the next mode. So this is the thing only. Any doubt here? If any doubt, you can ask me, please. Okay. Okay, then we'll just move for the next one. Now we have seen creation of new node, that is a single node, and traversing a linked list. Here we just assume this linked list is being created, but actually we have not seen that how to create that linked list, right? So here we'll see that how to create the linked list. Now see, for the creation of the linked list, we have these the three steps. So first step, see, as we are creating a new list, so it means initially your list is not having any node. It means your linked list is empty, right? So when we can say linked list is empty, so if your start value or head value is having that null value, in that case you can say that linked list is empty, right? So here we are assuming that head node or head pointer is a start pointer, and initially we are considering that start pointer value is null. So that's why that we can say that initially that link is empty, right? Now suppose you want to create the linked list, so we need to create one node. We want to attach that one node to the start. Again we want to create the new node. Again we can append that node at the end of the that existing list, again create new node, and again append that newly created node at the end of the list, right? So this is the way of creation of the linked list. So first step is create a new node, right? Because as we are creating a linked list, so first create a new node, and that new node is a single node you just created, okay? First you need to know create a new node, how to create a new node. Already I just told you how to create that new node. Second, check the value of start. Now we have that new node in your hand. Now suppose you want to append that new node to the list, original list. Now before just appending this new node to that original list, you need to check that start value. If that start value is having null value, it means your list is empty. So it means you need to attach this newly created node to the start simply. And if it is not null, it means some nodes are already there into the linked list. So in that case, you need to attach that newly created node at the end of your list, right? So these are only two steps. So here, first step is create a new node. Second is a check the value of start. If start value is having null value, it means linked list is empty. So attach newly created node to that start. And that statement I have written here, start equals to temp. And we know how to create the new node, right? And this temp pointer is for the creation of the new node. So using this statement, we can attach that newly created node to the start, right? This one. This is when your start pointer is having null value. Now suppose start value, start node is not, start pointer is not having null value, then what we can do? Attach node, that newly created node, at the end of list. So to attach at the end of list, what we can do? Take one external pointer, say suppose ptr, and using find function, you can find out the address of last node, like this. Suppose your ptr is now here using this one, this find last function, right? So what we did, we created, suppose in second case, this list is there. Now we want to attach newly created node after this 40. So before just attaching, you need to take one pointer and you need to traverse that pointer till last node, and then whatever is the newly created node, that address we want to store instead of this null, so that we can say this has been attached, right? So here use find function to traverse PTR and at last node. So using this one, we can traverse and store new value, new node address in the last node link part. You can see here PTR of link equals to temp. So this is assigning the temp value into the PTR of link, right? And you can return that start here. So I have just shown here these two steps. Now what is your first step? See, consider you have a start pointer, right? And initially that start pointer value is null and address of the start is 300, right? And I have created new node using that get node function, suppose, right? So this is a created new node. So new node base address is 4000 and that base address is stored into the temp. Yes, any doubt? Someone, mic is on. Okay, thank you. So see, this 4000 we have stored into this temp. So now 4000 are here into this temp. Now what we are checking first, you can see here, check the start value. If start equals to null, then we need to attach newly created node to the start. So you can see here the start is null, the newly created node is this one. What is our aim? Simply we need to store this 4000 into the start pointer, and where that 4000 is, that 4000 is already here into temp. It means only just assign this temp value to the start, so that arrow will be created here, right? So you can see here this one. Getting my point? So if start equals to null, then simply whatever is the temp value that you just assign here, before just assigning, that value of the start was null. Now it has been updated with this statement, start equals to temp. So this pointer has been pointed to this node. It means now for this, we have two pointers, this one and this one. So now this is the having no use. So only that start pointer is important for us. Now we can say this is our linked list. This is your first step. Second step is what? Suppose we have created new node and that start value is not null. It means that linked list is not empty. You can see here this one. This is the step two scenario. We have created this new node using this temp pointer, right? And that value is 40, that base address is 4000, and that base address 4000 we stored here into this temp, right? Now you can see here start value is not null. It means this linked list is not empty, so it is having some nodes. So here in this example, that linked list is having three nodes, right? Now how we can attach, or see, first to attach this newly created node here, we need to access this node. So how do I access this node? So to remember this one, to access any node, we need external pointer to that node. Now if you see here, there is no any external pointer to this node, so we cannot access this node. But see, in this case, only first node is having one external pointer, that is a start. So we can access only this node using start. But we cannot access this one, we cannot access this one without external pointer. So to access this one, we need to assign that external pointer to this or to this, whatever, right? So in this case, what I can do, I can take one more pointer, that external pointer, that consider that is a PTR. You can assign that PTR to the first node and you can traverse this PTR till last node. Now consider that PTR is here, right? Now once we are having PTR here, so it's simply because the name of this field is PTR of link, then only here we need to say PTR of link equals to this temp, so that link will be created. You can see here what I did. I have taken this pointer initially here and traverse this pointer PTR till the last node. Now what is the name of this field? That name of this field is PTR of link. You can see here PTR of link, And here, whatever is this 4000, that 4000 we have into this term. So that we have just assigned to this. It means the name of this is Peter of link into this, that temp value is there, right? So using this statement, we can create this link. This link we can create using this statement. Getting my point? So Peter of link equals to temp. So this is the second step. I think it's very simple. Only two steps are there. First step is this one. When your start is null, so in that case you need to create this link. And if suppose start is not null, then in this example we need to create new node and we need to link only this node at the end of the node, right? So here for that, just take one pointer, bring that pointer till last node, and whatever is this field name, that is ptr of link, this one. So in ptr of link you need to store this 4000 here, because this 4000 we have stored into this time. So that statement I have written here, right? So in this way we can create the link list. So if you have any query, you can ask me, please. So this function I have just given here, right? So this is what start, initially start we assume that is to be null. And these two pointers we required, that we have seen temp is for creation of new node and ptr is to traverse, and that start is for the head node, right? And here you need to decide how many nodes link you need to create. So for that, this number I have just accepted, and that number of nodes we can create, and we can create the linked list. So you can see here, create a new node. Once we create here that new node, then we checked this one. If start equals to null, then we can assign that start value here. If suppose start is not null in else part, so using this function we can bring that ptr at last node, and only simply write the statement ptr of link equals to temp, so that newly created node will be attached to the last node, and finally return this one. You understood this? So this is to create a linked list. If you have any kind of query, please ask me, because this is very critical. Actually I don't have that board facility, that's why I'm just trying to explain you on the PPTs only. And if anyone is from the Pune, and if he can come to the college, then in that case, if he's having any kind of difficulty, I can explain on paper also. Okay. So this is a creation of SLL. Now we'll go for the display. Display is very simple. As I said, this, once we know how to traverse this PTR, right? So while traversing only, print this PTR data and PTR link, PTR data and PTR link, PTR data and PTR link. So only if you just skip this semicolon, then inside this you can print this data value, link value, data value, link value, data value, link value. So that display is very simple, this one, right? So take PTR, PTR equals start, PTR is not equals to null, because I need to print that last node also. So that's why I need to pass this, the last node also. So that's why PTR is not equals to null. I think I just told you here, if you see here, you can see here, finally, when that list is complete, so that PTR will get that value null here, right? So in this example, I just told you, getting this? So here, simple, this is a function like for I equals to 0, I is less than n, and I plus plus. And inside this, you can print that. See, one of the correction you can see here, in few compilers, that unsigned int that is not considering, so you can use that p, right? This one. So this is for the data and this is for the address. So PTR of data and PTR of address or link that you want to print. So in that case, you can use this way, right? And see, this is not the operator considered. This is simply arrow, right? So don't say okay, this is a pointer operator or something, because this is in double quote. Getting this? but this is a operator. Here this arrow operator, and here also arrow operator, here is also arrow operator. So but this is not this is for the representation, you can say the spacing or something also, right? So I'll just tell you the one simple program. In that case you will understand this, right? So this is the display. Now how to append node at begin and end. And already you have seen end means the creation of the list if it is not empty. So simply see the begin, append node at the begin, right? This one. So what we can do here, first again, suppose this is the linked list, this is the original linked list, don't think this one right now. So only you can consider this as a linked list, this one original linked list, and we need to append that newly created node before this stem, right? Before this stem, it means at begin. So what I can do, so in that, first you need to create new node which you want to append begin and begin. So first create that new node. Suppose I have created this new node, and new node that base address is 500 that we have into this stem. Now what would be our aim? If the two steps are here, if you change this 1000 value to 500, keep in mind, if you change this 1000 value to 500, it means this start will point to this. This is one step. Second step is, whatever is this 1000, this 1000 or this 1000, I need to store into this node link part instead of this null. I need to store so that this link will be created. That's it. Only two steps are there. So first is what? First create new node. You can see. Second is create a link. This A I just given purposefully, because don't assign the start first and then this first. This is the sequence. First you need to create this link. So this link is what? Temp of link. This field name is what? This field name is temp of link. You can see here, this is a null part. Here you want to store address of this 1000. So name of this is temp of link. So temp of link, you can see here, this temp of link equals to this start value. Whatever is the start value, that is 1000. That 1000 means address of this first node. So this one. So this link has been created. Only you need to write this temp of link equals to start. It means this link has been created. Now next step would be what? Simply we need to point the start to this. So how do we this? If we change this 1000 with this 500, so that will be changed. You can see here. This link, how we can detach this one, and we are attaching, or we can say we are just creating this new link. And here initially it was 1000 in the start, now it is 500 this. So that statement would be, this B statement is start equals to temp. Means here I want to store 500, and that 500 is value of this temp. So here start equals to temp. Only these two steps are there for appending node at begin. So here I just return the steps, create new node, create a link A, and assign temp to start. That's it. So if you see here, right, this is the creation. Sorry, what happened now? This one, right? So only these three steps are required there. Now append, add, and is what? This is simple. Like you consider this as a original linked list or something. You can see here this one. So this is what? Just appending node at end. So this is original list, suppose till this. And simply you need to take one pointer PTR, assign initially to the start, traverse that PTR till here using find last function. You can traverse, and only this statement, PTR of link equals to temp. So this will be, this link will be generated. So append node at end is what else part of your creation of a list? Append node at end is what? That is a else part of your creation of list. You can see here, creation of list, this one. This is else part of your linked list. You can see here, this one. Whatever is this part, this else part. So this is what append at end. Already I just explained you this part. So consider this as the original list. Take one pointer ptr and traverse that ptr till here, and you just create this link. So you can see here, taken ptr, traverse till this, and created this link using this statement only. So this is what append node at end. So this is append node at end. Only now end is else part, and that append node at begin, this is a new thing. That is only. And see, if you understand this one, then I'll just tell you this is used in the stack also. This that same concept we are using in stack also, right? So this is append at end. Any doubt here? See, if you are having any kind of doubt, or please ask me. You just interrupt me and you can ask me doubt, because this is the very important part from the data structure. Once we understand that linked list, then and then we can understand the trees, graphs, and something, right? So most important part from the data structure is the linked list. So this is append node at end. Now we'll just move for the next operation. Next, that is a search. Search is the somewhat similar to find last function or just traversing your PTR. Only here, search means not always we go at end. We search particular element something. Like suppose you want to search this 30. So what we can do, we can accept the value to search, like suppose this 30. Take one pointer and assign that pointer to start. So here we have assigned that PTR to the start and traverse this PTR till that particular value or at the end of list. Right? You can see here traverse PTR till the value or end of list. So either if suppose that node is not present in your list, so you need to traverse this PTR till end of list, and you can say that search is unsuccessful. But suppose if node is present, that value is present in any node, then you can traverse that PTR till that node only. So here consider that the searching node is 30. So we taken PTR here and traverse this 30 node, and we can return this node. So that search is successful. Right? So this is the very simple one. You can see here that function is also given for PTR equals to start, it means assign, and PTR is not equals to null, it is for unsuccessful search, and PTR of data is not equals to value. It means if PTR data is not equals to value, just go for the increment. So PTR of data is not equals to val. This val is we have taken this value, and PTR equals to PTR of link. Right? So this one. So simply, and at the end you just put the semicolon because we are simply returning that address. So whatever the address we have returned, and once we get this address, then we can say PTR of data means that 300 of data is 30 and 300 of link is something like 4000, this one. Getting this? So this is the search, the function, and search, the searching, how to search the node from the linked list. Getting? So this is similar to your find last function. Only here, this and condition we have written here, that is PTR of data is not equals to val. This is for the successful search and this is for the unsuccessful search, right? So this is the searching. Searching is very the simple one. Now, the important one is the insertion. Insertion and deletion, these are the two most important the operations in the linked list. Here these steps I have written here. For the insertion, we need to create new node, and then we can insert that newly created node after any node into the linked list or at particular node. Now whatever the thing I am just explaining, that is after that node I am just explaining here. So enter a node after which you want to insert. So first you need to know after which node you want to insert that newly created node, right? Then create new node to insert. Now again, see, this searching is important here, because suppose after this 30 you want to insert newly created node. So we need to get this node first. And once you get this node, after this node, then you can insert it, right? So that's why traverse PTR till that value or end of list. End of list is when if that search is unsuccessful. And after this, only two statements are required. This is temp of link equals to PTR of link and PTR of link equals to temp. So I'll tell you how it would be. So now consider this, these two statements, I'll just explain it again. Okay. Now here with this example, consider this is the linked list. Okay. Now you want to suppose insert that newly created node after this 20, this one, right? After 20, you need to insert this newly created node. That newly created node is this. 1 minute, that value, I'll just change it. This should be 25. 25, okay. This one, right? Because 30 is already there. So after this 20, you need to insert this node. So that step would be first, you can create that link from here to here, means from 20 to 25 and from 25 to this 30, and you can detach this link. Whatever is this link from this 20 to 30, that you can remove, and two links you need to create from this 20 to 25 and from 25 to 30. Getting my point? So for that, what I can do here, see, this 3000 I need to store on this, the link part of this stamp. And here, instead of this 3000, I need to store this 5000 so that these links will be created. So how I can see this 3000 already we have stored in this PTR link part, right? 3000 we have in this PTR of link part, and this 2500 is having in the temp, right? So what we can do, if we store this 3000 into this one, so this name of this field is temp of link equals to PTR of link, because this value is here, so this is PTR of link, means temp of link equals to PTR of link. This is to create the link from here to here, you can see here, right? So first is this link and second is this link. So this sequence should be there. If you change the sequence, then your operation will not be successful, right? So here, first I need to create this link. So this link, how? This is the temp of link. You can see here, temp of link equals to PTR of link. This PTR of link, because the 3000 is here in this PTR of link. So temp of link equals to PTR of link. And then you can create this link. So that is PTR of link equals temp. So this is a PTR of link, this one. Here I need to override this 3000 with this 2500. So this link will be created. So you can see PTR of link equals to temp. Have you understood this? So this is the insertion of node after the particular value. So only these two statements are most important, temp of link equals to PTR of link and PTR of link equals to temp of link. I have just given here in this tape, temp of link equals to PTR of link and PTR of link equals to temp of link. Getting my point? So this is the insertion. And now last operation, that is the deletion, that we will see. Again, for the deletion, again, same concept, we need to apply that element you need to search. That element which you want to delete, that first you want to search. Like here, the 20 we have searched, and after this 20, we inserted this one. Now for the deletion, we need to search that element to delete. You can see here, this is the insert or the function. So it's very simple, that same whatever the things I just explained. Here enter the node after which you want to add. So that is value, suppose consider, and using this search function we have brought this pointer till this, right? And if PTR of data equals to value, then create new node and temp of link equals to PTR link and PTR link equals to temp. So this is the insert function. This is very simple function, right? So whatever step I just told you, the same steps I have written here. Now go for the deletion. Now in the deletion, somewhat the tricky, we can say, because here we need the two pointers. So I just told you here the PTR and previous, these the two pointers are required. So first accept the node value which you want to delete. So the node which you want to delete, that you first accept it from the user, so that that node we can delete it. Now take two pointers, one is a PTR pointer and second one is a previous pointer. Now see, the purpose of this PTR and previous is, PTR pointer is for the deletion of the node and previous pointer is used to create the links. So PTR pointer is to delete that particular node and previous pointer that is used to create the links. So that two pointers we need to assign to start and traverse both pointers parallel, you can traverse. So that traversing is what, one will traverse till that value and one will traverse previous node of that value. So here the statement I have just written here, for start PTR equals to start, PTR is not equals to null, and PTR of data is not equals to that value. This is for the unsuccessful search, right? And here simply this is a complete statement because semicolon is here, and this is a complete statement, semicolon is here. Now these two statements are written into the last part. Previous equals to PTR and PTR equals to PTR of link. This is for the increment, and before incrementing you need to assign this PTR value to the previous one. So I'll just explain you with example so that you will understand. And then if that value is the equal with this data, then we can delete that node, and accordingly you can create these links. This one is the one link and this one the second link, right? Because sometimes you need to create the first node, so in that case you can use this statement. And if suppose that deleting node is not first node, then you can create this link, right? And whichever node we have deleted, that you need to free, otherwise that node will be there into the memory. So we need to free that node. So that's why one dynamic the function that we are using here, that is a free PTR, right? And finally you can return the start. So I'll just explain with this. You can see here, suppose this is the original link list, 10 20 30 40, these are the nodes into the link list. And suppose you want to delete this 30. So see, one pointer I just forgot here. I'll just create this. This again required here, and the name of this will be previous. This one, right? This one, right? And one more again, sorry. I think one more. Here we can say but this is actually not required, this one, right? Only this is important one, but for understanding I can use this one, right? Now see, suppose this is the original link list and you want to delete this node. So suppose user enters this 30th node, you want to delete it. Now what we can do, we can take two pointers, one is a PTR and second one is a previous, and traverse these two pointers. Like see, when PTR will come to this, so previous will come to this. When PTR will come to this, the previous will be here, and if PTR would be here, then previous would be here. So parallelly these two pointers will traverse, right? Now in this case, the deleting node is 30, that's why PTR traverse till this and previous traverse till this, right? Now that simple thing is what, you want to delete these two links. And the new link you want to create, that is this one, because this node is not there. So how do we create? So here that initial value is 3000. So we need to update this 4000 with this 3000. So if you override this 4000 over this 3000, so this link will be created. Getting this? So actually, again here, this would be the 4000, right? Because in the original list, 3000 is here, 4000 is here. Now the name of this field is previous of link and name of this field is PTR of link, right? So if you store here 4000, this name is previous of link, this is for 3000, and there you just store this PTR of link. So if you see this statement, previous of link equals to PTR of link, it means this will be overwritten with this 4000 using this statement. Previous of link is this equals to PTR of link is this, means that 4000 will be overwritten here. Getting? And this link will be form. I think it's very simple. You can see this function here. Of you can see this is to traverse both pointers PTR and previous. You can see this for loop. At the end of this for loop, that semicolon is there. And this is what, if PTR of data equals to val, and here if suppose deleting node is first node, then start equals to PTR of link. It means suppose you want to delete this node, right? Now what you can do here, so you can free this PTR, but before free you need to shift this start pointer from here to here. So how do I transfer this start from here to here? You can say simply start equals to start of link. You can see this is start equals to start of link or PTR of link, because both are same. You can use PTR of link or start of link here, so that start will shift to the next node. And if suppose the deleting node is not first node, then previous of link equals to PTR of link, already I just told you. And whatever is this deleting node, that is PTR, that is free. So you just free this node from the memory so that this will be deleted. Getting this? And finally you just return the start. So these are the operations on the linked list. If you have any doubt, please ask me. One program, I'll just tell you, very small program, right? If you are having any doubt in this, you can ask me. Till this, I'll just show you that program. Okay, you can see this is a template. Already I have written this template. You can see here the template. Already you people are knowing this template. This is a blank template. You can see here the two cases I have just taken, create list and display list, right? And these are the two cases and third cases to exit. So empty cases I have taken here. So if you see here, I'll just run this template. So you can see it is compiling, and you can see here create list and display list. This create list, display list, and there is nothing into these cases. So simply I'm just running this template. So if I enter one, so you can say it is running perfectly. Again, if I say want to continue, so if I say yes, again it will ask the same menu. And suppose you want to display, just put the two. Again, it is running successfully because it is asking again whether you want to continue or not. Then suppose say no, then it will exit from this one, right? So it means this template is running perfectly. Getting this? Now what we will do, we'll just write something into these cases, right? So first I'll just write the calling statement into this. Suppose start equals to create start. This start is a pointer that I'll just take here, right? Of node. But see, before this I need to create that node, right? Node is what? Struct node, then data, and stroke node, this is link, this one, this is a node structure, and I'll just create my data type, type def struct node node, right? This one, I think this is for the creation of node. Now I've just created one function that is a create start, and here initially we are assuming that list is empty, so that's why in start I have just assigned here null value. Now I have returned that function already. I just told you in that PPT that function, right? So that same function I'll just write paste over here. You can see that whatever function I just given in PPT, that same function I just copied here, right? You can see here, this is if link is null, then start equals to temp. Otherwise, you can traverse your link list using PTR, using this statement, and PTR of link equals to this one. Now here only we have this get node function. So I need to copy that get node function also. Right, so this is for the creation, right? I am not writing any the display function, only here I need to write prototypes. See, while just writing prototypes, you just write here after this structure declaration, because you are using the, sorry, not here, after this, right? Because you are using this node data type, and that node data type you just defined here. If you write this statement before this, then this will say this is not the data type, right? So that's why after this you want to write this. And one more, the function, this one, okay, and just write here node, sorry, get me, right? I'll save it and just try to run this. Running, and if you see here, enter first option, so suppose one, and how many nodes you want to append into the list, suppose four nodes, suppose 10, 20, 30 and 40, right? Four nodes we have just inserted. This is working perfectly. And if you say yes, and if you go for the second, so this will not they display anything, because I have not written anything into the case 2, right? So if I say 2, so this is simply running, and if I say no, then exit, because I have not written anything into this case 2, right? Because I want to check only case first. Once this case is working, then and then I go for the second case. Already I just told you, just before just completing case 1, don't go for case 2. Because if some errors are there in case 1, then first you can completely solve these error, and then you can type the case 2. Now as case 1 is working perfectly, so I'll just go for the case 2 display. That same display I'm just copying here, whatever the display I just given you in the PPT. And also I need this prototype here, right? And here now I can call this display and say here, don't forget to pass this parameter start, because initially that start value was null here. Now using this, we just updated that start value, and that updated start value we need to pass to the display function, right? So I'll save here and I'll just try to run again. Running. And you can see here again one, so five nodes, suppose 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50, five nodes accepted perfectly. Again, suppose yes, and second try, that is two, you can see here. See here, first node is 10 and address of this next node. You can see here, this is the address of next node. And whatever is the array, this is for the representation, you can see here after 10. Now second node is this one. This arrow is simply for the representation, and this is the address of the next node. You can see this one. This is third node. This is the address of next node. This one. This is 40. This is address of next node. And you can see last node link part is null. Getting point? This last node link part is null because we know in linked list last node is having null value. Last node link part is having null value. And here if you want to say no, then it will exit, right? So you can see here, this is whatever I just told you in PPT, that same thing I just copied here and I have just run here, and this is working perfectly. Okay, so I think the same thing you can go for the insertion and deletion also here. So you can write that, you can copy that code from the PPT. You can write here, type here or paste here. Accordingly, you just write the cases and this prototype and you just run it. Okay. So this is about the linked list. If you are having any doubt, so please ask me. Otherwise, we'll stop.